I'll never forget what you've done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget, no, never. Tell me, how can I forget what you've done for me? How can I forget how you set me free? How can I forget how you brought me out? How can I forget? No, never. Oh, Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Yeah. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget, no, never. Tell me, how can I forget
what you've done
for me? Oh, how can I forget how you set me free? How can I forget how you brought that he has shown toward us, and we thank God for allowing us to have our pastor on out tonight. Amen. We thank God for her and give God glory and honor. Brother, you see some of your grandchildren?
Great.
Great? Oh, my goodness. Thank you, Jesus. We thank and praise God for them. Amen. We thank you, God, for help Crosby being out in the midst. Minister Quinn, amen. Tamika, thank you, Lord, for the church. We certainly praise God for another day's journey. Amen. I hope y'all can hear me.
Amen.
Amen. All right. Amen. Thank you. I just got the mic up here as a prop. It ain't working. So we praise God for how good he is to us. I often say that God is good to us.
Yes.
And his mercy certainly endures forever.
Yes.
And as we get ready to go before the Lord in prayer, we certainly want to remember men and women and children everywhere that the Lord will continue to save and add to the church daily such as should be saved. And we certainly want to give honor and pray for the McHale family and the loss of his mother. Last week we went to the funeral home, so we had Bible study on last week. So let us pray one for another, that the Lord will continue to bless us and help us, to encourage us. Amen?
Yes.
We need encouragement from the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Do we have any other particular prayer requests?
Bishop, I just want to ask a prayer for all of the children 18 and down.
Yes. Bless them.
Amen.
Amen. Make good choices. Yes. Because especially, you know, when you get around that 18 years of age, you need to start making good choices. Because then you're held more accountable, so to speak, for the choices that you make. All right. Well, we're going to ask the church to stand. And let every heart pray, oh, gracious Father.
Yes,
We come before you, Lord, to just say thank you and praise you for your grace, your mercy, your love, and your kindness. We thank you, Lord. Father, you bless each and every soul, bless each and every one of us to be here on tonight. We ask you, Lord, that you continue to keep our hearts and our spirit. Help us, Lord, to be the servants you're being, calling for us to be, and especially in these last few days. Lord, we ask you to bless each and every request that's been made known to you. Remember those that are 18 and down, Lord. We ask you, Lord, that you touch their hearts and their minds. And Lord, we ask you to remember men and women and children in all walks of life. Lord, we pray, Lord, for salvation. We pray for deliverance. We pray for sound minds. Lord, keep us. Put a hedge of protection about us. Protect us from danger, seen and unseen. And Lord, we ask you, Lord, to take charge of our Bible study on tonight. Lord, send forth a word of strength. Send forth a word of encouragement, Lord. Help us, Lord. Hallelujah, to be able, Lord, to receive with meekness the engrafted word to the saving of our soul. And Lord, we praise you and give you glory and honor. We give you all thanks. Hallelujah. We bless your name. Echo. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. We praise you and give you glory and honor. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for the spirit of thanksgiving, the spirit of praise, the spirit of worship. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you. Hallelujah. We give you glory and honor. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Yes,
hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. The spirit of thanksgiving came into our midst. Hallelujah. The spirit of thanksgiving. Lord, we thank you. Lord, if you don't do anything else for you, for us, Lord, we thank you. Magnify your name.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
Lord. Thank you,
yes,
Lord. Remind me of the psalmist said, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good and his mercy endureth forever. If we can turn tonight to the book of Colossians, chapter number 1. Thank you, Jesus. We want to talk tonight about our favorite subject, which is Jesus. I ain't got to ask you if that's your favorite subject. I know it is. Hallelujah. Go ahead and tell the cross. She'll be yours. So I got your name right now. It took a minute. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. All right, starting out at verse number 1. Thank you, Jesus. And Paul, he wrote this epistle to encourage this particular church, Colossae, to encourage them to keep on keeping on, because he saw something in them. You know, when you see something in somebody, you should encourage them to keep on keeping on. You know, because there's a lot of negative things people can get involved with. And especially when you're working for the Lord, there's a lot of negativity that the enemy tries to throw you off track with. And what Paul did in this epistle, he was encouraging them to continue on doing well for the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So as we see, you found it? All right, go ahead.
Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God, and Timotheus,
all right, Paul is introducing himself to this particular church because, you know, this, I don't want to say the church was new unto him, but you know, they needed to know that he was carrying some weight, had some authority with him. So he introduces himself as an apostle, you know, one that had was numbered with the 12 and that had seen Jesus and that had been taught by Jesus. And notice he says, not of the will of man, but I'm an apostle of Jesus Christ. He put Jesus' whole name there, Jesus Christ. Amen. And he was anointed by the will of God, not by the will of man, but by the will of God. He's establishing himself as an authoritarian in this word. So what he's about to preach or teach unto them, they would receive it. Amen. And Paul is not walking as a novice, but as an apostle that's been called by Christ according to the will of God.
Yes.
And y'all know the story of Paul when he was anointed. He saw Jesus as he was on the road to Damascus on his way to do evil. And the Lord interrupted his game. And you know, won't he do it? You can be on your way to do evil. And the Lord will interrupt your game. And you know, knock you off your beast. Blind you.
Hey!
Hallelujah. Put you on. He told I want you to get on Straight Street. And go down to see Ananias. Put him on the street. The Straight Street. Won't he put you on the Straight Street?
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. So he saw and he said, "Who art thou, Lord?" He said, "It's Jesus whom thou persecuted." And in the book of Acts, he tells him, he said, "I've appeared unto thee for this purpose, to make thee a minister." Amen. To deliver you from the people to whom now I send you to. Amen. Thank you, Lord. So that they can receive repentance and remission of sins, turn them from darkness to light, from the power of sin unto God. Ain't that a whole mission? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And Paul, he said when he received his anointing, when he received the baptism and the Holy Ghost, thank you, Lord, the Bible says that he straightway preached Christ and him crucified. So he didn't play around with it. Straightway, he got serious for the Lord. Amen. So he did that in verse number 2.
To the saints and faithful brethren in Christ, which are at Colossae, grace be unto you, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. So we're in Colossians chapter number 1, verse number 2. And notice he's writing to the saints, to the faithful brethren in Christ. And we can call ourselves that. We can put our name there. Amen. We're the saints of the Most High God, separated from the world by this gospel, by the gospel of Jesus Christ, which is the power of God unto salvation. So notice the encouraging words that Paul says to them, to the saints and faithful brethren in Christ. Amen. That's what we ought to be. We ought to be faithful brethren together, a family. Together in Christ Jesus, which are at Colossae. Now notice, he uses this word, grace be unto you, and peace. Amen. Mercy is receiving that which we don't deserve. Amen. And grace, let me back it up. Grace represents that which we receive from God that we don't deserve. That mercy is not receiving that which we do deserve. When God shows us that mercy, amen, we all deserve a horrible punishment because of all the things that we did. But God has mercy upon us and don't allow that to happen, amen, because of his grace. Amen, because of his grace. And because of the grace of God and the mercy of God, he can have peace with us. Yeah. Amen. Here go my man right here. Can you keep my sound? Thank you, Lord. God can have peace with us. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. And that's what's necessary.
Yeah.
Amen. We need God's grace and we need God's peace.
Yeah.
Amen. That peace that passes all understanding.
Amen.
Amen. That is able to keep our hearts and our mind. Yeah. We need that. Amen. Don't we need that?
Yeah.
We need that every day. The Lord said, "I will keep thee in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on me." So in order to achieve this kind of peace, I just want to put the exclamation point on it. This kind of peace doesn't come to the world. This kind of peace comes to the saints of God that are striving to be like Jesus. Amen. This kind of peace is supernatural. This kind of peace passes all understanding. This kind of peace will keep your heart and your mind.
Yeah, let's go.
This kind of peace will establish you. Huh? Thank you, Lord. And give you the ability to walk through your storm. To walk through your test. With being encouraged. Amen? Hallelujah. So we see here then, he says, grace and peace from God. Notice where that peace comes from. From God, our Father, and our Lord and Jesus Christ. So this isn't a typical kind of peace. Yes. This is a peace that is supernatural and miraculous. Amen? That God gives unto you. Thank you, Jesus. All right, verse number 3.
We give thanks to God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
Praying always for you.
Yes. Now, this is Paul's staple. He always prayed for the saints.
Yes.
This should be our staple. We should always pray for the saints. You know, I love it when I'm doing mine in my own business and I feel the prayers of the saints.
Yes.
You know, you can feel it when somebody earnestly praying for you.
Yes.
Why? Because we're in the body.
Yes.
We're in the body together.
Yes.
Amen. You can feel it. Have y'all felt that before?
Yes.
I say, man, somebody must be praying for me.
Yes.
Somebody must be calling out for me. And the Holy Ghost itself.
Yes.
It will make intercession for you. With groanings and moanings, amen, that cannot be uttered. He knows. Amen. The Lord knows. Prayer is essential. Amen. Prayer is essential. We should pray earnestly one for another. Prayer can change things. Amen. Prayer can move things. And if it doesn't change you or the thing, but it can change you in the thing. Amen. Hallelujah. It's your connection to God. Amen. Hallelujah. And through prayer, if you're praying right for the will of God to be manifested in your life, you'll get your answer. You know what I found out? As the Lord showed me this years ago. He said, because I was wondering if my prayers are being heard. And the Lord spoke to me, said, are you praying my will? If you're praying my will, then your prayers are going to be heard. Amen. And I used to pray, Lord, give me wisdom, give me knowledge. I still pray for that. Don't get me wrong when I say that. But I'd be praying for wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And I'd be wondering, Lord, are you going to give me the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding? And the Lord let me know. He said, it's my will to give you that. It's my will to fill you up with that. So you don't have to continue to wonder about it. I'm going to give it to you. Then the scripture said, blessed are they that hunger and thirst after righteousness, and they shall be filled. Amen. The Lord delights. He delights in them that delight in him. You ain't got to wonder. Hallelujah. The Lord delights in you if you delight in him. Thank you, Lord. My God. Hallelujah. And when we begin to pray and begin to seek after God, let us pray with confidence.
Yes.
Amen. A full, the Bible says, assurance of faith. Because when you come to God, you got to believe God.
Yes.
You got to believe that he's hearing your prayer.
Yes.
You got to believe that he'll answer.
Yes.
Believe that he has more than enough ability. Amen. To do that which is necessary. Praise him. Thank you, Lord, because your God, he's able. Thank you, Jesus. He's able. And when you seek God and pray, because it was working at one time. Thank you, Lord, because I turned it on and I don't know what happened after that. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, there it is. Hallelujah. There's that grandmaster there. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And God will bless you. If you just believe and seek after him.
Yes.
Amen. Now, what I said earlier was about God. He loves those because the Bible says that the eyes of the Lord are going to and fro. It's going to and fro. Amen. Seeking for those that are calling out for him. Looking for those that call on his name. Looking for those that desire to want to know him. Amen. So as you pray with that kind of confidence, believing and trusting God.
Amen. Knowing that as long as you're praying according to the will of God, He hears you and He'll answer you and He'll make it happen. Amen. Won't He make it happen? Hallelujah. Sister Jackie. Just hit you all of a sudden. Yeah. Just go, just be magnified in the name of the Lord. Yeah. Because truly, if we're in the body, amen, and the Bible says that Jesus can be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. If we're in the body, then we can be touched because we're in His body. Yeah. If He can feel it, we can feel it. Yeah. You follow me? Thank you, Lord. And as we begin to earnestly pray one for another, God honors that. God honors intercession. God honors when we pray for people. Not think, see, what it is, I'm going to tell you what it is. When we stop thinking about ourselves and think about somebody else, oh, that makes God happy. That just moves God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. My God. When we start praying for other people, seeking after other people and wanting God to bless others, that's why He said rejoice with them that rejoice. Weep with them that weep. Amen. Pay attention to others. Amen. Hallelujah. My God. So prayer is the key. What verse you in, Pastor? Can you read that again? Oh, can you read 3 again?
We give thanks to God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you.
Now notice how He's making intercession for the people. Amen. We ought to give thanks for people. Regardless of, the Lord showed me a definition of unity. Unity is not necessarily everybody thinking the same and agreeing together. But we agree and think the same about Jesus. Amen. About our mission. Amen. About the work of the Lord. That's the unity that the Lord wants us to be involved in. And when Paul says we give thanks unto God and our Father and of the Lord Jesus Christ, we ought to give thanks for people. We ought to thank God for people. Amen. Thank God for people. Even those that may oppose you, give thanks for them. Amen. Those that hate you and despitefully use you. Don't walk around with a frown on your face and dealing with people that done you dirty. Just give thanks. Amen. You ain't got time for that. all that negativity. Give thanks. Because if you start thinking and dwelling on all that negativity, you'll be called Debbie Downer in a little bit. Amen. Your whole countenance will change. Amen. Your attitude will change. Somebody will say, Mommy, can I have a drink of water? No! And they just ask you for a drink of water, but you've been thinking on your mind about all that negativity and you're lashing out on others. Amen. So just give thanks. Amen. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Give thanks. And then he said, praying always for you. Read.
Since we heard your faith in Christ Jesus.
Uh-huh. Now notice, he's thanking God for some positive things that are going on in their lives. Yeah. Amen. That's encouragement. Yeah. Especially, this was a baby church. And Paul was trying to build that church up.
Yeah.
And so he's talking to them, since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and the love that you have to all the saints. That's encouraging. We ought to encourage one another, strengthen one another, amen, hallelujah, and have faith one for another, pray one for another, am I right? All right, read.
Verse 5.
Uh-huh.
For the hope which is laid up for you in heaven,
yes,
whereof you heard before in the word of the truth of the gospel.
Now notice what he says. I'm praying for the hope which is laid up for you in heaven. He's talking about that hope of salvation, that hope of deliverance.
Yeah.
Now the Bible says, now abide faith, hope, and charity. And it says the greatest of these three is charity. But don't cast away your hope. Yeah. Amen. That hope is not like you're waiting for a bus to come by and say, well, I hope it show up. No, it's different from that. This hope is a sure thing. This hope is a sure thing, a thing that has already taken place, and we're walking through the manifestation of what's already taken place. So we have a hope, amen, that lies beyond the grave. He said, any man that have this spirit in him, hallelujah, thank you, Lord, hallelujah. You got something that you're hoping for, but it's sure. Amen. It's sure. It's solid as a rock. And when he's describing hope, he's talking not as a hope that, well, I hope it shows up. I hope it happens. But a hope that is sure, that causes you to go through your tests, to go through your storms, to be able to stand. Now notice what he says. For the hope which is laid up for where? For you in heaven. It's that same hope that Jesus said, I go away to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there ye may be also. It's that same hope. Hallelujah. He said, let not your heart be troubled. Neither be afraid. Your labor in Christ is not in vain. Amen. Your labor in Christ is not in vain. So what does Paul say? Be steadfast. Be unmovable. Always abounding in the work of the Lord. Why? Because your work is not in vain. That's your hope. And then Paul is really bringing this out through his other epistle in the book of Galatians. He talks about a hope. The book of Ephesians. He talks about a hope. Hallelujah. That has already been manifested. That has already been completed. That has already done. Amen? Hallelujah, my God. So you're just waiting for the manifestation of it. Amen? Amen. So notice what he says. Verse number 3. Verse number 4. 5. All right. Read that verse again.
Well, the hope which is laid up for you in heaven.
Uh-huh.
Whereof you stand before in the word of the truth of the gospel.
Now, that's where you find your hope in. The word of the truth, amen, of this gospel.
Yes, Lord.
Man, the gospel of Jesus Christ, which has power with it, which has anointing with it, which is able to transform you, which is able to deliver you. And he's speaking of that hope which Jesus himself manifested to us by his lifestyle. When Jesus came on the scene, he immediately preached, repent ye. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. We're here. Amen. And the gospel that he preached, his death, burial, and resurrection, has power. Hallelujah. Paul said, if only in this world we only had hope in Christ. We all are being most miserable. Amen. Hallelujah. We got hope beyond the grave. We got deliverance. We got strength. We got power. Amen. Now I'm going to say something. I'm going to say something here. Hallelujah. I'm going to ruffle your feathers just a little bit, because oftentimes we think this gospel is about us coming out of sin. But this gospel is also about you walking in power, walking in authority. Amen. Using it as a strong foundation, and that the gates of hell shall not prevail against. We got to, as the Bible tells us in the book of Hebrews, chapter number 6, he said, leaving the principles of the doctrine and go on to perfection. How do you do that? By following after this gospel. Amen. By living the word of God. So it's more than just, I'm glad I'm delivered from sin. Amen. But that shouldn't be my only testimony. My furtherance of testimony should be I'm living for Jesus. Through the power of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. That through this gospel, I receive my healing. Through this gospel, I receive my anointing. Through this gospel, I've been set free. I've been led over. Hallelujah. Through this gospel, I've been rejuvenated, revived. Isn't that what Jesus said? He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. For he hath anointed me to preach what? This gospel to the poor. Now notice, that the power in it to heal my broken heart. I should have a testimony that this gospel, it healed my broken heart. That I was bound and it set me free. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on here, somebody. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And now that I'm walking in the liberty, I'm walking in the freedom to do good works. Tell somebody, do good works. Do good works. You got power to do good works. You got power through this gospel to tread upon serpents, to tread upon scorpions. You got power through this gospel to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You got power in this gospel to stand as a foundation and as a solid rock. I am to the most shock. Hallelujah. You got power. And glory. Hallelujah. Not just to come out of sin, but to live a life. Come on here, somebody. To live a life free from it, but a life that glorifies your God. That's the power of the gospel. It glorifies your God. Hallelujah. My God. Hallelujah. I don't just want to be free from sin. Thank you, Lord. I also want to walk in his power. I want to be healed through his anointing. I want to experience the joy and the power of this word. I want to know the depths and kabosh. Hallelujah. Of what he has to offer. Hallelujah. My God, that's what Paul was referring to when he said, I want to know him. I want to know him in the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering. I want to be made conformable unto his death. If by any means, hallelujah, I can attain from the resurrection of the dead. Amen. Hallelujah. I know we preach down through the years. That's some tall talk. But that's the mindset we got to have. Let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, it's one thing. You can experience water by wading and putting your feet in it. Amen. But it's a whole other ordeal when you jump in it. Amen. Come on here, somebody. I just don't want to experience Jesus on a foot level. I want to experience Jesus mind, body, and soul. Get all the way in it. Amen. Get tired of tangled up in him. Amen. Come on here. I want to know him. I want to know some wisdom. I want to know some knowledge. I want to know some understanding. Amen. I want to be strong in the Lord. Hey, glory. Come on here, somebody. Thank you, Lord. Amen. This gospel, is also part of the armor. Amen. Huh? Let your feet be shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Amen. That's your armor. Amen. That gives you the ability to fight and to stand against the enemy. Especially when he's trying to throw darts of confusion, darts of doubt unto you. Amen. You can just tell the devil, because he lives, I'm going to live. Yeah. Hey, hallelujah. Y'all follow me? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So, when you're dealing with this gospel, notice what he said. Wherefore, you have heard before in the word of truth of the gospel. This gospel is true. Amen. And I'm going to say this and I'm going to move on. That there is no other gospel whereby men can be saved. There's no other.
No other.
Don't look for another. Amen. So be sold out in this. Be sold out in this. Amen. Don't look for another. Huh?
It's the only truth because it's been proven and it can't be changed.
You come on here. Did y'all hear what she said? She said, it's the only truth because it's been proven and it can't be changed. Yes. Amen? Yes. Am I right? Hallelujah. Am I right? Like I said, she said, is she right? Hallelujah. It can't be changed. Thank you. Jesus, in fact, he made this bold statement. And he said, all that came before me were thieves and robbers. Yeah. Moses, he changed the word of God. Thank you, Lord. Amen. He made some revision in it. But Jesus, he didn't make revision in the word. He stood on the word. Amen. He stood on the word. Abraham, he came and lied. Didn't he lie? Thank you, Lord. So you know, they got some, I'm not saying that to cast a disparaging thought upon them, but I'm saying that to say that they got issues. Amen. They had some issues, but Jesus, he stood firm. Huh? Jesus, hallelujah, he stood firm and steadfast. Hallelujah, glory. Hallelujah. He did what was necessary. Amen. Hallelujah. And he did it all to the glory of the Father. Amen. So we can count on him. The scripture says there is no defilement in him, no guile in his mouth. So he can't lie. Amen. Impossible for him to lie. Amen. So you can bank in this. Amen. You can trust in this. Hallelujah. So what Paul is trying to tell, I'm getting ahead of myself in this scripture, but I feel it here. Paul is trying to tell them, live to the fullest. Because you've got the best. Live to the fullest. You've got the best. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I don't look for another gospel.
No.
I don't look for another Savior.
No.
Amen.
No.
Thank you, Lord. I look for him. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Read, Pastor.
Verse 6.
Uh-huh.
Which has come unto you.
Yes.
As it is in all the world.
Yes.
And bringeth forth fruit.
Yes.
As it is done also in you. Mm-hmm. Since the day ye heard of it.
Yes.
And knew the grace of God in truth.
Now, Paul is saying, this says a profound statement. When you receive this gospel, the product of receiving this gospel, it should produce something in your life.
Yes.
Amen. Nobody comes to Christ and not be changed. He said, if any man be in Christ, he's a what? New creature. You've got a change going on.
Yes.
Amen. All things, old things, have what? Passed away. You get rid of those old things. And all things have become what? New. Thank you, Lord. You produce holiness. You produce righteousness. There's a product. Amen. There's a change. Jesus said, I am the vine. And my Father is what? The husbandman. He said, every branch that's in me that bear fruit, he does what? Purges it. So it can bring forth more fruit. And if you're not bearing fruit, he said, he take it away. Amen. Thank you, Lord. So your lifestyle should improve. Your lifestyle should improve with Jesus. Now, I'm going to say this, that when you first start out with the Lord, all hell may break loose. You may say, what is this have I gotten into? And I thought I was coming to Jesus for my life to get better. You with me? But I'm reminded of, you remember when Jesus was in the graveyard? He was walking in the graveyard, and there was a lunatic man there, and he was filled with legions of demons.
Yeah.
And the Father desired Jesus to heal his son, and Jesus prayed for the man. He said, your disciples couldn't do it. You know? Hallelujah. But Jesus prayed for the boy. Amen. And if you read in the scripture text, it talks about how those spirits, before they came out, they rent him. They tore him. Amen. And then after that, he was clothed and in his right mind. Amen. When you come to Jesus,
come on,
you're going to go through something.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
The enemy is going to try to rend you.
Yeah.
And tear you up.
Yeah.
To keep you from moving forward.
Yeah.
But if you just stick with the blessing,
yeah,
if you just walk with the Lord,
yeah,
you'll be clothed and in your right mind.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. There's a process. Amen. There's a process. Thank you, Lord. And I didn't mean to get into this part, but you got to look at it. The scripture says you reap what you sow. When you get into Christ, yes, all your debt is paid and you're forgiven, but you still did some things that you have to pay for.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
That you have to pay for. And that's called reciprocity. Thank you, Lord. So you keep living, and you'll outlive the punishment, if you're allowed to say, the soul, the reaper.
Yeah.
Amen? Just stick with Jesus.
Amen.
Some things he's just gracious to not even let it affect you. Amen. But some things that you've done, you've got to go through.
Yeah.
Amen. If you had some outside marriages or some outside children, and you had to pay some child support,
yeah,
he'll save you, but you're still going to be responsible for that child support. Thank you, Lord. And you just bless God until you're done. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. You was known in the world as a liar and a thief and a busybody. When you get saved, some people gonna believe the report, but some people ain't. they gonna want to see some change. Amen. They gonna want to see some fruit. Amen. Hallelujah. So you just keep on living. Amen. Just keep on enduring. Amen. Thank you, Lord. And as you, as an individual that is young in the Lord, as you receive God's word, the sanctification process begins. Amen. The process of change happens.
Yes.
And as an individual starts to apply that word in their life, amen, just live the word in its simplicity. The following after, if you allow me to say it, even the Ten Commandments, thou shalt not have any other God before him. Amen. Don't take the name of the Lord God in vain. Amen. Thank you, Lord. And don't make any graven images. Am I right? Keep the Sabbath. We keep the Sabbath by resting from our old sins,
yeah,
our old habits.
Yeah.
Amen. Honor your mother and your father. Don't commit adultery.
Yeah.
Don't lie. Don't steal.
Yeah.
Amen. Don't murder. Am I right?
Yeah.
Don't covet. Amen. If we do those things, those first four of those things deal with our relationship with God. Amen. Thank you. The last six of those things deal with our relationship with each other. Amen. And if we follow that, Amen. Hallelujah. And we got to keep this thing simple. Huh? Thank you, Lord. What I mean by that is the Lord tells me to pray, to forgive. I don't have to receive another revelation from the Lord. Huh? Should I forgive her or should I forgive him? The Bible says do that. Amen. You don't have to receive another revelation from that. Huh? Am I right? The Bible don't want you to steal. Well, should I steal this or should I not steal this? The Bible has already said, don't steal. You don't need a deeper revelation. You don't have to wait for the Holy Spirit to move on you. To say, don't steal. The Bible says that. So live out in simplicity. Amen. Live out in simplicity. The Bible says give. Amen. I ain't got to wonder, should I not give my tithes and my offering? The Bible says give. Amen. Don't wait for a revelation. Don't wait for a mood or a song to come by. Amen. Do what the Bible says. Amen. Hallelujah. Y'all with me tonight? Thank you. And that's what Paul is after in this epistle with these saints. Amen. He said, God has called you to greatness. God has called you to power, glory, and honor. God has called you to bring forth fruit. And he says, how do you do that? By walking worthy. How do you do that? By living its lifestyle. Right. Amen. Thank you, Lord. You know, one of the most powerful things that an individual can do is hear the word and accept it and do it. Amen. You're talking about honoring God. God ain't honored with your great sacrifice. God is honored with your obedience. Amen. Come on in, somebody. Hallelujah. Obedience. How that scripture go? Thank you, Lord. That obedience is what? Come on here, somebody. King Saul, he wanted calling himself sacrifice. Amen. And which he, you know, y'all read that story. He was lying from the beginning. Amen. He had some issues. Amen. He had some pride issues. He didn't want to humble himself. Thank you, Lord. And God gave him chance after chance after chance, but then he had to foreclose on him. Amen. And Saul, Samuel went there and showed him how to sanctify the Lord. And he told him that obedience is better than sacrifice. Amen. God has shown us what's required of us. Amen. Hallelujah. God has shown it to us from babies. He's shown it to us. A baby know when he's lying and trying to hide it. Amen. Thank you, Lord. They know when they're doing bad. They know when they're having a temper tantrum and don't want to share. You follow me? They know what they should do. But you know, that's why God gives us the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost empowers us, amen, to do what we should do. Hallelujah. Am I right?
Amen.
All right, read, Pastor. Where we at?
Seven.
Uh-huh.
As he also learned of Epaphras, our dear fellow servant,
yes,
who is for you a faithful minister of Christ.
Read.
Who also declared unto us your love in the Spirit.
Amen. There it is again.
And to desire that you might be filled with the knowledge of his will and all wisdom and spiritual understanding.
Now, when you're praying for your brother and your sister, you can pray for them for the healing. You can pray for them to get the house, get the material things. But first and foremost, this should be your prayer concerning them. That they be what? Read that again.
For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you.
Yes.
And to desire that you might be filled with the knowledge of his will.
Now notice, we ought to pray one for another that we all be filled with the knowledge of the will of God.
Yes.
Amen. Because that's the only thing that matters. What else matters? Does your will matter? Does my will matter? Does Satan's will matter? Only will that matters, your boss will don't even matter. The only will that matters is the will of God. Amen? And God wants us. He desires us to be filled with his knowledge. If you seek after God and desire to know God, God wants to show himself to you. He's looking to show himself strong in those that seek after him. Amen? Hallelujah. And why not go after the only thing that matters? Now notice what he says. Be filled with the knowledge, read?
Of his will.
The knowledge of his will, that's the accumulation of facts concerning the will of God.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. And he wants you to get it so you can live it.
Live it.
Amen. God wants you to live it.
Live it.
Hallelujah. I read the knowledge of his will.
In all wisdom.
That wisdom, notice he said, he's really quoting the book of Proverbs. Amen. He wants you to be filled with all wisdom as well. And that wisdom is the ability to live this thing through the knowledge and understanding which God supplies. So wisdom is actually the application. Amen. Applying. Living it. Amen. It's one thing for an individual. Let me say this. An individual can know and understand everything they need to know and understand about God, and if they don't live it, they'll be lost. Amen? If you don't know as much as they know, but apply the little bit that you do know, you'll be saved.
Yes.
Y'all didn't hear me. Y'all didn't hear me.
Amen.
It's all about application. It's all about applying. You know, because they were getting into people they call agnostics, and they and the Bereans, they wanted to know everything about the Word of God and about everything else, but they didn't truly want to apply it. And when you don't apply God's word, and you have all kind of wisdom, knowledge, you have all kind of knowledge and understanding, and if you have no wisdom, it profits you nothing. Amen? You got to apply this word. Look at Solomon. Solomon gave his heart, amen, to know, searched out things. But what was his end? He had all them wives, had all them concubines, gave his heart, and they turned his heart against the Lord. He didn't apply the righteousness of God's word to his life. You've got to apply the righteousness of the word of God to your life. It doesn't matter if you can quote the Bible from A to Z, but are you living? What are you living? What are you living? That's the key.
Amen.
That's what God looks at. What are you living?
Yes, sir.
Amen. And that's what Paul is trying to bring to the people. Live this thing. Amen. Live it to its fullest. Not in complication. In simplicity. Doing what's natural. Amen. Hallelujah. According to the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Y'all with me tonight? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. My God. All right. Read. Praise the Lord, Sister Charlene.
Verse 10. That ye might walk worthy of the Lord, unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work.
Now notice that you might walk what?
Worthy.
Worthy. God wants you to live a lifestyle that reflects him. worthy of the Lord. Let this mind, what? Which is also where? In Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be what? Equal with God. Amen. Found himself in the fashion of a man, he did what? Humbled himself. And became what? Obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God did what? Highly exalt him. Amen. God wants to highly exalt you. Hallelujah. And how does he highly exalt you? By you seeking after him. By you wanting to know him. And by you living this word. Amen. Walking worthy of the favor that God has given unto you. Amen. You got to walk worthy of this favor. Hallelujah. Elevate your mind. Hallelujah. Walk in obedience. Walk in authority. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, part of this walking worthy is you know, oftentimes we live beneath our privileges. We think, is God for me? We think, can I attain this? We think, well, I don't know, I don't deserve this. Amen. And on a natural level, you don't deserve it, but God deserves it. You are God's servant. Can I just teach you for just a moment? You are in a kingdom, representing a king. Amen. Hallelujah. And God doesn't want you walking around like a pauper. God doesn't want you to walk around like a homeless person. God doesn't want you walking around like a defeated individual. Hallelujah. Because Christ, and come on, shout. Christ redeemed you. Christ saved you. Christ anointed you. That's why he said you're more than a conqueror. Elevate your mind. Walk worthy of this vocation. Wherever you've been called, live this thing.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Live in the anointing. Live in the overflow. Live in his power. Amen. Call on your God. And you know, when you get in a situation, when you get into problems, God revels in that. Because he wants to show himself strong. He wants to show himself mighty. That's why you were created. That's why you were designed. So that God can show himself through you. That's why you were called out of darkness into his marvelous light. So that God can glorify you, which then the people will glorify him. Come on here, somebody. Hallelujah. Walk in his anointing. Walk in your faith. Walk in his grace. Live in his mercy. Amen. Hallelujah. Walk by faith and not by sight. You've been redeemed. You've been set free. Am I right? Hallelujah, my God. Come on, give God a praise for your freedom. Thank you, Lord. Your kingship. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. No more. No more should we walk around like we ain't nobody. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You know, I forget how many years it was. They tell you. You know, when they had freed the slaves, and then on that Juneteenth, that's when the last slaves found out they were free. And I forget how long that was.
It was 2 years.
Thank you.
1867.
Amen. 2 years after that. Amen. That they had realized that they were free. Amen. And during that time, they thought that they were enslaved. And they did everything to their master. Amen. You know, let us not be like that. God doesn't want you to realize you in this thing 20 years and then you just now realizing the freedom that you have. The liberty that you have. That's tragedy, isn't it? That's a waste of time. Am I right? Thank you, Lord. And the master's calling shots. Thank you, Lord. Don't be like that. Amen. My God, that made me mad just thinking about that. Thank you, Lord. Don't be like that. realize the freedom that you have in Christ Jesus. You know, I heard the preacher preaching, it kind of made me laugh. Elder Crosby and I, we laugh about it sometimes when we talk about it. We go into a room in heaven, he opened the door and show us some stuff, and we see a lot of stuff in there. And he said, oh, you don't want to go in there. He said, why not? I want to go in there. I want to see. And he said, all right. He opened it up. And he said, well, whose stuff is that? He said, that's all the stuff that you could have had. If you'd just been walking and doing what you should have done.
That's right.
Amen. We are not leave anything on the table.
Yes.
Amen. Don't leave stuff on the table. Thank you, Jesus. I myself, you know, you be talking to people, making contracts with people, making deals with people, and then in the end, you find out, well, I could have gotten more, I could have gotten some more favor, I could have asked for more. It was there for the asking. You just didn't feel worthy enough to ask.
Yes.
Go for it. Huh? Your God is great. He can do exceedingly and abundantly. Amen? Hallelujah. I ain't one of the prosperity preachers, but just live in your prosperity. Hey! Hallelujah. My God. We're backing up. Live in his prosperity. Hey! Come on here, somebody. According to his riches. According to his grace. Now that elevates it, doesn't it? Huh? Am I right? According to his riches. According to his grace.
Yes.
Amen? That's what walking worthy means. Living a simple life, being obedient to his word, and living it in a royal, holy way. Simple as that. God wants to show you off. Amen? You are his workmanship.
Yes, Lord.
Created, designed in Christ Jesus. Notice, prepared unto good works. God wants you to do good things. Amen? Y'all with me? Hallelujah. Refuse the evil and receive the good. Am I right? All right. That's great exploits in the name of the Lord. All right, read. What's it say?
That you might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing.
Now notice, you've got to please him. Amen? Unto all pleasing. Please him. Don't look to please anybody else. Huh? Amen. She said you won't. Please God. The eyes of a man never satisfy. Amen. Please God. Live to please God. Amen. Paul is giving you the formula by which how to walk worthy. Please God. Read. Now, in every good work, in every work, be fruitful. Amen? Everything you do, produce fruit.
Amen.
Everything. Your praise produces fruit. Your tests and trials produces fruit. Everything you do, produce fruit. Amen? Read.
And increasing in the knowledge of God.
Now notice, there it is. And everything that you experience. Now, I want y'all to hear me on this. Everything that you experience that you are going through even now should be increasing your knowledge of God.
Yes, sir.
It should be increasing and multiplying your knowledge of God. Everything.
Everything.
Amen? If you look at this world, and the book of Proverbs tells you, that wisdom crieth out in the marketplace.
Yeah.
Amen. It's everywhere.
Yeah.
Amen. And everything that you experience, you should see it through the lens of God.
Yes.
Amen. Why? Because he's the creator.
Yes.
He's the author of it.
Yes.
He's the key. Amen. And if you start to see everything through his lens, and not through the lens of worldliness,
right,
deceitfulness,
right,
and worldly lust. You and look through the lens of God. Look through his eyes. He'll increase your wisdom. He'll increase your knowledge. He'll increase your understanding. In other words, if you just stop and acknowledge him in all your ways and allow him to direct your path. Amen? The Bible tells us about Jesus. He said, the grace of God has appeared unto what? All men. Teaching us. See, Jesus is a great teacher. He's teaching us that we should deny ungodliness and worldly lust, and that we should live wild, soberly, and righteously. Where? In this present world. Amen. God wants you to manifest his will and his desires in this present world by doing the basics, by doing the simple things. Amen. Hallelujah. That's how you lay a solid foundation. If you do the basic things, then he'll give you the more intimate things. If you're not faithful over a few things, he won't make you ruler over many. But if you be faithful, come on here, somebody.
Yes.
If you be faithful, be faithful with until the end. To the end of what? To the end of God saying end. Yes. Hallelujah. Just be faithful. Hallelujah. If your ways please God, God will translate you.
Yes.
Just like he did Enoch. God will uphold you. Just be faithful. All you got to do is just show up. Be faithful. Do what God requires you to do. Amen. Just be faithful. Am I right? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. My God. You teach a Bible study, only two people show up, be faithful. You preach it, only one person show up, be faithful. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hey, I'm going to put it this way. I don't believe God sent a preacher to preach to pews. Or amen. But if nobody show up, preach your word. Thank you, Lord. Put it out there in the atmosphere. Be faithful.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Be faithful. Be faithful until we end. Be faithful unto death. Amen. Hallelujah. I heard a preacher say, death won't excuse you because you got to do it before you die. So be faithful. Hold out to the end. Am I right? That's what God is looking for. That's the kind of church God wants. From faithful folk. Amen. Don't you know, I'm going to move off from this point, but you can accomplish great things with a few great faithful people. Amen. It's not about the number with God. y'all don't hear me. It ain't about the number with God. Amen. It's about the faithfulness with God. Amen. God has shown in his scriptures how they were outnumbered. Amen. And they only had a few, but God showed up. Amen. Turned the situation around. Amen. Hallelujah. You can be two or three gathered together in his name, and God will show up. He'll show up. Show up. Show up in power. Show up in the anointing. Amen. Confuse the enemy. Turn little into much. Boy, it's glory. Do y'all believe that?
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's how we got to live. Living for the miracles of God. Y'all understand what I mean by that? Living to see his miracles. Living to see his signs and his wonders. In other words, when it don't look like it's going to happen, that's when your faith should be the more built up, because God has just set it up for him to show himself strong and mighty. Amen? Believe your God. Hallelujah. When is it a time that I shouldn't believe God? Now, you should always believe. Always trust him.
Always
seek out him. Always keep his commandments. Always worship him. Always bless him at all times. Always. Hallelujah. That should be our mindset. And now listen, and we should do that with joy. We should do that with excitement. We should do that with expectation. Amen. Hallelujah. Y'all with me? Hallelujah. Thank you. My God. My God. The darker you get, the lighter you should get. Hallelujah. The more you should worship him. The more you should praise him. Amen. When should you give up?
Never.
Amen. When should you turn your back on God?
Never.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. This sounds pretty simple. But when people get pressed to the road, their mind changes. Amen. Thank you. When the Bible talked about Abraham not staggering at the promises of God, he was talking about at that moment when he decided, Abraham did, that he was going to offer up Isaac as that sacrifice. Amen? And the proof of it is because when he got ready to slay Isaac, the angel of the Lord, or the Lord spoke and said, "Now I know you fear me." Amen. You feel it? You follow me? Thank you, Lord. He had to come to that point. We have to come to that point. Abraham was a great man, don't get me wrong. But on his journey, he had some stumblings with his faith. But after that, he came to a point in his life where he realized that I need God. And that God is able to raise him up from the dead. My God, you got to come to a point in your walk with God and say, I need God. And I trust that he's able to raise me from the dead. I trust that he's able to heal my broken heart. I trust that he's able to supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. So I'll do whatever he says. I'll live however he wants me to live because I believe God. Hey, hallelujah. We got to come to that point. Hallelujah. As the deer panteth after the water brook, so panteth my soul after thee, oh God. We got to come to that point. Be fully persuaded.
Yes, Lord.
That's what God wants.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We come to that point.
Yes.
Be fully persuaded.
Yes.
Trust your God. Believe your God. Don't turn back on your God.
No.
Be like Job. If I perish, I perish. No, that was Esther. If I perish, I perish. But Job said, though you slay me, yet will I trust you. Amen. Thank you, Lord. That's faith. That's walking with God. In other words, we've got to walk with him as though nothing else matters. Amen. Nothing else matters. When we walk with him like that, we'll have Paul's testimony.
Yes, Lord.
He said that whether to live or to die is gain. No matter what I go through.
Oh, hallelujah.
It's gain.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm going to walk with him. Are you going to walk with him?
Yes.
Are you going to live for him?
Yes.
Are you going to bless his name?
Yes.
At all times?
Yes.
Hey! Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't let nothing separate you.
Yes.
Don't let nothing take your praise.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Don't let nothing take your worship.
Yes, Lord.
Don't let nothing take your God-mindedness.
Yes.
And in everything, get knowledge and wisdom of God.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. My God. My God. All right, read, Pastor. We almost done.
11.
Uh-huh.
Strengthened with all might.
Now, note, when you gain and start walking with the Lord in all worthiness, being fruitful, increasing in the knowledge of God, God will strengthen you. Huh? Not with just some might. With all might.
With all might.
Amen. We quote that scripture. When you draw nigh to God, He'll draw nigh to you. And that's true. But you gotta realize when He's drawing nigh to you, He's drawing nigh with all of His fullness, with all of His strength, with all of His power, with all of His anointing. He's not leaving anything behind. Hallelujah. He's not leaving anything behind. Y'all know sometimes we halfway pay attention. God ain't never halfway paying attention. He's showing up.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And when He shows up, He's showing up to take care of business. So read, what's it say? With all strength, with all might.
According to His glorious power.
Now, God is blessing you according to His glorious power. Paul was letting them know that you're in something very special. You're in something very special. Amen. Don't give this up. Don't turn around from this. In other words, the deeper you get into it, the stronger you'll be. The deeper you get into it, the more you'll see His glorious power.
His glorious power.
And understand it. Amen. Read.
Unto all patience.
Now notice. Then God will fill you with all patience. You need patience, don't you? You need patience because it helps you to possess your soul. You've got to have the ability to wait on God. Amen. And while you're waiting on God, you can't murmur. You can't complain. Why? Because knowledge tells you that the children of Israel, when they murmured and complained, God got them. Amen. So that's what I'm talking about, the simplicity of the scriptures of the word. So when you're going through, you know the number one thing you should not do is to complain.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't
Amen.
Complain. Your God doesn't like that.
No.
He don't want you to be a whiny baby.
No.
Can't go through nothing.
No.
Amen. He wants you to be patient.
Yeah.
Endure.
Yeah.
Wait. Yeah. Amen. Hold out. And do it in such a way that glorifies your God. Simplicity. All right, read. What's it say?
Unto all patience and long suffering.
Now, notice.
But joyful.
He wants you to be long suffering. That's why He gives you the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost, part of the fruit of the Spirit of the Holy Ghost, is long suffering.
Yeah.
Amen. So, this long suffering, the world can't do it. That's why He gives you an anointing to do it.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, I'm anointed to do this.
Yeah.
I'm anointed to go through this.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. And when He anoints you, He gives you the ability to do it.
Yeah.
Amen. So if you're suffering a long, don't be sad because God has anointed you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
He's given you the ability to do it. Hallelujah. But we don't want to suffer. You know why? Because we haven't gained the knowledge of suffering.
Yes.
The wisdom of suffering.
Yes.
The fruit of suffering.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And then we don't truly understand that through the long suffering of God, God is really working some stuff out. God, we got to realize that if I'm suffering in this particular temptation, God ain't going to put no more on me than I can bear. So God got my back, and He's already anointed me. So I'm going to come on shout. I'm going to praise Him through. I'm not going to murmur. I'm not going to complain. I'm going to wait on God because shall come, he will come, and he will not tarry. Hey, Lord, come on and give your God a praise. Give your God a praise. Hallelujah. That's why that last verse, that last part, he said, with all what?
With
joyfulness. When you're going through, this is the last point we're going to make here tonight. When you're going through, you got to have you some joy.
Yes, Lord.
Amen?
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Didn't he say count it?
All
joy. Count it, consider it. All joy. It may not feel joys like joy. Amen? But he said count it all joy. God does not want you to go around murmuring and complaining. He wants you to go around praising and worshiping, giving thanks, praising your God. Amen? That's how he wants you to go around. And he wants you to have some joy. Amen? Thank you, Lord. Now, when you look at whatever you're going through the eyes of the Lord, and you're able to joy in it, to give thanks in it, that moves God. Amen? That moves God. It's like that cheese commercial. When that block of cheese start complaining, what they say? Not ready. Not ready yet. Amen? Not ready yet. When you dealing with what you're doing, and you murmuring, complaining, God said, not ready yet. Not ready yet. But when you can look whatever you're going through in the face and say, I will bless the Lord, I'll give thanks unto the Lord, and you magnify your God and be faithful. And be faithful. Thank you, Lord. Put your game face on.
Yeah.
Come in public. Put your game face on. Let me worship your God. When you go home, take off all your clothes, then you can weep and cry. When the telephone rings, hello, praise the Lord. What you doing? Oh, I'm giving God thanks. Y'all know how we do it. How you doing? Oh, I'm blessed. Don't we do it that way? Thank you, Lord. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Thank you, Jesus. All hell can be breaking loose. But you got to know who's in control.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You got to know who's able.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Him that's able to do exceedingly. No, who that's able to do exceedingly, and not only that, but abundantly. Not only that, but is able to do above all that we can ask for things. Now notice the latter part of that scripture, and I'm done. He does it according to the power that works in you.
Amen.
You supply God with a little faith, you have a little power. If you supply God with much faith, you'll have much power. The only thing that limits God is us and our knowledge of him. That's the only thing that limits him. Now I'm going to say something deep. God has designed it that way. It's a principle of God that he only works according to our faith.
Yes, Lord.
Amen? Because your faith is powerful. Y'all don't hear me. Y'all hear me?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. So if God has designed it that way, use God's design in your favor.
Yes.
Use God's design in your favor.
Yes.
Just like sowing and reaping. If you sow sparingly, you're what? If you sow abundantly, you're what? That's God's design. Use God's design in your favor.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Amen. You're a child of God. You've been walking with God for how many years? And you still squeezing together dimes and nickels. Look at how you've been sowing. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Look at how you've been sowing. Y'all with me?
Yeah.
Personal experience. I used to live from paycheck to paycheck. I started sowing more. Now I'm not living from paycheck to paycheck. My wife can testify to that. She don't want to, but she can. In other words, when the paycheck all around, there's still an abundance. There's still something in there.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
You know what changed? My giving. Now, I want y'all to hear me. You can pray till you're blue in the face. Lord bless me, Lord bless me, Lord bless me, Lord bless me. But if you're not operating in these principles, you ain't giving them nothing to work with. But if you start operating in the principles of God, God will bless you. Y'all with me? I thought I'd throw that one in there for free. Thank you, Lord. We certainly thank God for you. Amen. Amen. We pray. Come on, give God a praise. I enjoyed this conversation. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to ask my dear cousin, Pastor Moses, if y'all maybe she would stand and just talk it to us just for a moment. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thanks for this opportunity. I have been trying to get here, and I especially try to get here on Sundays, but I still do Sunday school online, and I can't get up off the line because we start at 10.